Hey, show and tell, we meet a local woman who spent an entire year knitting a handmade blanket.
And she did it one day at a time. Fox host Tony Martinez has her story.
Well, today my guest is Janae McMahon, and we are cozied up in a blanket, but it's not just an ordinary blanket. What makes this so special?
This is a temperature blanket depicting every day of the year's high temperature for the year of 2022, starting January all the way to December 31st.
And you made this?
I made this.
So every single line is a day in the year.
Yep.
And the color represents
the high temperature of the day.
You're kidding me.
No.
How did you think about even doing this?
I found this on TikTok and I thought, okay, this is something I could do.
But now, are you handy like this? I mean, do you normally do this kind of stuff?
No, this is the first blanket I've ever made. 10 feet, 5 inches.
10 feet, 5 inches long, and then weighs?
And it's 7.5 feet wide, and it weighs 16.5 pounds. I have always wanted to do something every day for a year, so I did do it every day. I am not fast, about 1 to 2 hours a day.
So this is the key with the temperatures and the corresponding color.
Yep, it's every 5 degrees. I have my calendar that I would write the highs and lows. I would use the Fox 12 app for my weather.
You know you're gonna make Jeff Fordrun cry when he finds out you have the weather app from Fox 12. He's gonna be so proud.
Anniversaries are in gold, birthdays are a confetti color, and the end of the month is black.
Is this a thing? I mean, I didn't know this was a thing.
It is a huge thing.
Who knew?
There's a whole community of us. In September, which is over there, I messed up and had to rip out the entire month. And so I'm posting online the frustrations of having to redo that all.
Huh.
And everyone's like, keep going, you can do it.
This really tells the story of a year in temperature, but also in your life.
Oh, yes.
What changes have taken place?
Well, we are having a grandbaby.
And so... Well, did that happen right about here?
Right about here. But, like, I see the reds thinking I was outside when it was 95 degrees sitting with this heavy blanket. This will be around forever. And
wow.
My grandchildren will be able to cuddle up in it. And...
Well, they're going to have to fight me because... I'm gonna do some cuddling up right now.
If I have 10 grandchildren, there'll be enough. They each can have a foot of it.
It's been such a pleasure to meet you, and thank you so much for sharing. What a special way of expressing your artistic talent.
Well, thank you.
And thanks for sharing that with us.
Yeah, it was a labor of love, that's for sure.
I know our weather department's gonna be so jealous. So, sorry, guys.
You know what I love about that is, you know, if you start a project and you feel like you're not that good at it, you might be inclined to give up,
yes.
Right?
Oh, no.
But she kept with it.
There's no giving up because when she says there's a community, it's global.
Yeah.
Like people from in Australia, and theirs are like the colors go opposite or something because of the weather being different.
Yep, it's winter, winter,
but no, summer. I mean, she said like, you know, when she had a rip out September, and they're like, go girl, you can do it.
Yeah, it's so, awesome. Yeah.
I have a question because it's so beautiful and such a labor of love. Will she do it again? I
mean, no.
Oh, really?
No interest in doing it again. And not because she didn't enjoy it. She's just that kind of person.
Yeah.
She's very artistic, and her house is full of art that she and her husband have made and furniture they've made, and she just wants to move on to the next thing.
Wow.
She wanted to do one thing where every day she did, like she was going to take pictures of the sunset. Well, that isn't always practical here, so this was the alternative, but no, she did it. She wants to move
so
on.
Better.
That's pretty neat.
And,
I love it.
And it does really tell you how many more cold days we have than warm days.
Yeah.
It's like, there's an awful lot of blue on there.
That was her most common color was the pale gray.
Yeah.
That's right.
Oh, really neat, Tony.
Ran out of that yarn.
Nicest woman you ever want to meet. So I really appreciate her.
It was fun to see that. Mm. And initially you're like, somebody's knitting.
Yeah,
how interesting is that?
Yes. But, so good.
You found it all there. So that was good stuff. We're going to go out to Eastern Oregon University.